just put it to a wonky angle to make him look really crazy. And there he is. And now to cover him in snow. No, not real snow. PVA glue. Two parts glue, one part water. Mix it with a bit of water and just slop the glue onto your snowman. Cover his chest, his face, his nose, his hat, even the base. With PVA glue, and then just pop on strips of kitchen roll. And kitchen roll is nice and strong. I suppose you could use loo roll or tissue paper, but let's use kitchen roll for this. Make it nice and strong. Cover the whole snowman in two layers of kitchen roll and glue. And then leave it to dry overnight. And when he's dry, watch this. You have something that looks like that. Look at that. The snow with a kitchen roll and PVA glue has gone nice and hard. And see what I've done here? I've even rolled up some kitchen roll, maybe little buttons in front, stuck those on, and given little bubbly cheeks, just to give a 3D effect. Now, even if you used white kitchen roll, it's a good idea to coat the whole thing in poster paint or acrylic paint, bright white, to make it nice and snow white. And then you can put on your detail. I'm just going to draw in an eye here to show you. It's difficult to get it on to start with. If you can get my pen running out, but if you make a mistake at this stage, you can always just paint it over with poster paint or spray paint it on. In goes his eye. Now for his nose, again, I'm just going to use some paint here, make it nice, bright, and orange, I think. Because after all, snowmen do have carrot noses. You can, again, take a lot more time to do this, doing it more carefully. And when you've done all your detail on your snowman, you'll have something. Oh, there he is. Something that looks like that. What is going on? Look at that. And you see what I've done here? I've painted his buttons black. You've even got some tinsel for a scar. And I've dabbed some blue on there for his cheeks, making him look frosty and cold. And I've given him some tinsel hair. And I've painted his hat black. And I've just dabbed on some glue. And given him some glitter snow. And there he is, a snowman that never melts. So, you don't have to keep them out in the cold. Try it yourself, your very own Christmas snow. You know, Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without a Christmas tree in your bedroom. Come and have a look at this. Now, to make a homemade Christmas tree, you need to cut two big sheets of card from a cardboard box. Now, you can make this as big as you like or as small as you like. I'm going to do a big one. Draw a vertical line down the middle of each sheet of card, and then simply draw a Christmas tree shape onto each piece of card. Now, you just have to keep it really simple, because this is just going to be the sort of skeleton, if you like, of your Christmas tree. Just drawing a big triangular shape like this to both sheets of card. And then don't forget your pot. Now, a couple of little tips here. You must make that vertical line go right down the middle of your tree and down the middle of your pot. And also make sure the bottom of your pot is straight, so you can use a ruler for that. And then mark the halfway point of your Christmas tree like that. I'm just guessing, but you should measure it because it does have to be accurate. And do the same on your other one. Draw that onto your piece of card. Mark the halfway point like that. And then cut yourself a strip of card with a straight edge. Now watch this. This is very important. Place your strip of card on its side, going up the vertical line on one of your trees, and go up to that middle point. So that's up to the middle point on one, and draw a slot like that, the width of the card. And then on your other one, draw that slot so that it goes down from the top of your tree to that middle point. So again, you've got another slot, but this time from the top of the tree to the middle. So it's one from the top and one from the bottom. So you have something that looks like that. Then cut both trees out, including the slots, and you'll end up with something that looks like this. Look at that. Two trees, two slots, one top and one bottom. And then paint your pot. Now, if you paint your pot in a nice bright red colour, like this, you can use poster paint or acrylic paint. It gives it a real good Christmassy feel. And do that on both sides of each tree. And then, little trick here, if you just paint on PVA glue, some little star shapes all over your pots. I'm just going to do it really quickly here. there to show you. You don't have to do a neat start and just be a series of crosses like that. And I bet you know what I'm going to do now. Yes, just get a pinch of glitter, sprinkle it onto the glue like that, and then just shake off the excess like this, and watch this. Voila! You've got a star. Do that all over your pots, and you'll have stars all over your pots. Looking like that. Look at that. Looks fantastic, doesn't it? And then just simply slot the two trees together like that. And there you have, it's a sort of skeleton Christmas tree, isn't it? A slot Christmas tree. And now to fatten it up. Very easy to do this. Scrunch up a piece of newspaper into a ball. Take some sticky tape, attach it to your paper ball, and now this is what I call Christmas stuffing. You stuff it onto your tree. There you go, nice paper ball there. Stuff it right in to the corner, like that. And then take some more newspaper, make some more balls, put some tape on, and stuff them in. And it's just a case of building up the shape of your tree by stuffing in some scrap newspaper and taping it into place. And when it's finished, you'll have something that looks like this. Look at that. A nice, fatly stuffed Christmas tree. And you've got a lovely Christmas tree shape there. And I've even put some extra sticky tape on just to hold it all into place. And now to put on the leaves or the green colour, take a pack of crepe paper or tissue paper that's green. Now I'm using crepe paper because it's cheaper. And just lightly crunch it this time, not into a ball. And then take some PVA glue, just the ordinary white school glue you get in the squidgy bottles. And then just dab some onto the bottom of your tree, like that. It's best to start at the bottom rim here. And just dab it into place. And then stick on your crepe paper. And just, again, apply a bit of Christmas stuffing there. And there it is. And look at that. It just hangs like a leaf in place. Cover the whole of your tree in the same way, and when it's finished, look at this. You have your own homemade Christmas tree. Look at that. There they are. All your leaves beautifully stuffed into place, and you've got this fantastic shape with your pot at the bottom. And now to decorate it. The difficult bit. Take a meter of sticky tape. And I get really annoyed when I do this. Watch this. Try and fold your tape over into a loop and then just scrunch it into a loose ball. That's not easy, sometimes get into a right angle. And then just pinch a bit of the sticky part of your ball of tape and then stick it into some glitter. Just dip it into the glitter, holding on to a sticky bit, and then pull out the glitter, shake off the excess, and then just attach it to your tree using the sticky bit that you've been holding on to. There it is. You just literally stuff it on again. And you can make loads of different shapes, loads of different colours. Look at that. I'm going to use red glitter there. It's like using red and gold just to match my base. And again, another one on there. And you can put as many as you like on your tree. And when you've decorated the whole of your tree, you'll have something that looks like this. Look at that. Gold and red glitter balls decorating the tree. Brilliant, isn't it? Try it yourself, a homemade Christmas tree for your own bedroom. You noticed how this time of year everything's really Christmassy. The shops, the decorations, presents. But have you ever wondered, what is it that actually makes things look Christmassy? Is it snow? Is it sleigh bells? Or could it be this stuff? Holly. You know, it's amazing. You can draw holly onto nearly anything at all and make it look Christmassy. Now watch this. I've got an ordinary cheap envelope and I'm going to turn it into a Christmassy envelope just by drawing on some holly. Now if you've ever taken a close look at holly, or indeed if you've ever held holly in your hand, you'll know that it's got spiky leaves. Now they're really deep green leaves, but they've got spikes on them. So when you're drawing your holly leaf, it's just a case of drawing a load of spikes along the edge. And it's a bit like drawing ocean waves, like that. That ocean wave there, and one upside down, and there you have your holly shape. And again, colour it in this really deep green. You know, it's amazing how many things to do with Christmas are green and red. Well, maybe that's got something to do with holly. Because again, if you take a close look at the holly, you'll notice, as well as those spiky leaves, it's got those really deep red berries. So I'll just put those on my picture there. And I'm just going to outline the whole thing. You don't have to do this, but by outline it's a very thin black line. And it makes it look even spikier. I don't know whether you've ever held holly, but it can be quite unpleasant. So when you do see it at Christmas, steer clear. Around those berries, black outline, and of course a line down the middle of the leaves, and there it is. And if I do the same in the opposite diagonal corner, two corners, and there I've transformed an ordinary cheap envelope into a really expensive looking Christmassy envelope. You could try this. Take an ordinary piece of white card or thick paper, cut a rectangle, fold it in half and make some place cards for your Christmas dinner table by writing your guests' names on the front and just creating a border of holly around the outside. And look at that. I forgot to colour that one in there, so just finish that off. Again, I did the holly in exactly the same way. And I mustn't forget those bright red berries. There it is. And I think that looks like a brilliant place card for the Christmas dinner table. And you know, you can draw holly onto anything. It's best to draw green leaves and red berries, but if you've got something that's really strongly coloured, or it's already coloured green, and you want to do holly leaves on it, then try these gold and silver pens. And again, they give a really great Christmas look back. Just draw holly leaves the same way. Holly leaves don't need to be easy. You draw these upside down, right side of ocean waves, a couple of berries. Again, that gives a really good Christmas effect. Now, have you ever seen these things? These are brilliant. These are glitter and glue pens. And it's just a case of squeezing the pen, and the glue and the glitter come out at exactly the same time. It's absolutely perfect for creating really spiky holly. See that? Just squeeze it out at the same time. And when it dries, gives it a really good glittery Christmassy effect. And what I've done here is I've threaded some ribbon through a piece of card, and I'm just going to create a Christmas gift tag. In fact, there are lots of different things you can do with holly. Look at this lot. I've created some gift wrap just by drawing holly onto some pieces of paper.